This is the second part of the chapter biomolecules. In this video, we have oligosaccharides and polysaccharides. We had done the monosaccharides in the last video. This is the video on the polysaccharides. Polysaccharides have both oligosaccharides and polysaccharides. Oligosaccharides are the saccharides that come in between the polysaccharides and monosaccharides in the basis of number. We knew that monosaccharides have the number n in between 3 to 7, okay? And the combination of two monomers is called oligosaccharide, and the combination of many monomers is known as polysaccharides. Okay, so first oligosaccharide is disaccharide. Monosaccharides do not need digestions, and they are observed as they are because they cannot be digested. Furthermore, these are the simplest form in which any carbohydrate could be formed. Disaccharides need digestions. They can be hydrolyzed in a test tube. Following are the examples of disaccharides: maltose, sucrose, and lactose. Maltose is broken down by the enzyme maltase into glucose and glucose. That is, maltose is a combination of one glucose and one glucose. That is why it is disaccharide. It has two further monosaccharides combining to form it. Maltose is also known as malt sugar. It is present in the germinating seeds, and from the germinating barley, beer is prepared. The glucose and the glucose which combine to form maltose have a structure this. Okay, the fourth carbon of the right hand side glucose combines with the first carbon on the left hand side alpha D glucose, that is simple glucose, to form the alpha 1,4. Here is the carbon number 4, here is the carbon number 1, both of the other alpha glucoses, okay, and they form the alpha 1,4 glucosidic bond. Now if you see here, you will find that there is C, there is a hydrogen, and OH and OH. So OH and OH bond combine, and it would be like 2H and 2OH, but only one HO remains here, and the H2O is liberated, okay? That is how this works. Now, maltose is reducing sugar body as it has free aldehyde group on the right hand side. You can see this OH. We had mentioned about this in the last video as well. It is a reducing sugar. It has the reducing ion of OH. So that is why compound carbohydrates divided into oligosaccharides, polysaccharides. Oligosaccharides are the combination of around 2 to 9 monomers. Polysaccharides are the combination of more than 9 monosaccharides. Sucrose, it is also known as invert sugar. We know that sucrose is converted into glucose and fructose by the very popular enzyme sucrose or invertase, also written class 10th. Sucrose is also known as cane sugar or table sugar. That is the sugar we eat. It is storage product of sugar cane, and we know that it is obtained from the sugar and beetroot, but in our country it is specially grown or obtained through the sugar cane, not beetroot, but that's the way sucrose is obtained in other countries. And we had also read in the previous video that the fructose in its inverted form, that is in actual beta dextrose fructose, okay, that is how it combines with glucose to form sucrose. Now here if you see, alpha D glucose and beta D fructose have combined here to form our sucrose. Now this is exactly what I was talking about. Here you see that this is not the simple fructose, it is the inverted one, okay. And the order goes on like this, but in beta D fructose the order goes on like this, okay. So now it is like that. Here we have beta 1 alpha 1 beta 2 glucosidic bond, because the C2 of this and C1 of this, that is alpha D glucose, combined to form a bond. And as we had named the earlier one, okay, this is named the alpha D glucose, so alpha of C1. Now the first carbon, if you go clockwise, and here we have the second carbon, okay. So this is the beta D fructose. It is just that the number, the actual alpha or beta, that is the way they have been arranged in the open chain with the number of the carbon atoms which have been forming the bond, is taken as the actual number of the glycosidic bond. Oh, okay. Now it is a non-reducing sugar. That is because both functional group have reacted. Now you see that the functional group of this was here and the also this was here. There was no functional group on this side because it was just the opposite. We had just read that. So no free OH. Okay, there is OH, but just to see. Okay, it is CH2OH, not OH. And we know that on left hand side OH has no actual value. Only on the right hand side the OH is considered. Okay. Now lactose, it is also known as mixed sugar. Now lactase is acted upon by lactase to form galactose and glucose. Now let us recap that. Okay, maltose was formed by glucose plus glucose, sucrose was formed by glucose plus fructose, and a trick to remember also is that if you see fructose at last, directly hit that it is a non-reducing sugar. Okay. And now lactose is also galactose and glucose. Since it is having glucose at last, rote learn it that it will have reducing sugar because it has no exception. Okay, so it is very good to rote learn it, so no exception. So you can now this is also beta 1 comma 4 because both are beta beta, and here for carbon 4 reacts and here carbon 1 reacts. Both are, this is glucose, this is galactose. Okay, now reducing end is, we don't have to actually remember the form of the galactose, we don't have to remember structure. Okay, we just have to know that galactose and glucose react to combine to form lactose. Okay, now next we have trihalose, which is also a disaccharide, but it is present in the body of insects, that is hemolymphs. Okay, especially beetles. Okay, it is also present in fungi. Non-reducing sugar made up of two glucoside residues. This is just to remember 3 points: non-reducing sugar of two glucoside residues. Glucoside residues. Okay, this means that neither we have glucose or fructose or sucrose. Nothing. We just have two glucoside residues. Okay, that is something like not so advanced. It is something like primitive. And it is present in fungi and insects, nothing else. And the name is trihalose and it is a trisaccharide. Now trisaccharides, we have to study only raffinose, have to study only that its structure. Okay, only it has galactose, glucose, fructose. This is just to rote learn and nothing else, no structure or anything. And yes, since it has last fructose, so it will never have OH free bond on its right hand side. Okay, not on the left hand side, on the right hand side. And since it is having no free OH ions on the right hand side, it is a non-reducing sugar. Okay, since RHS is fructose. Okay, tetrasaccharides. Now example is stachyose. Stachyose has two galactose, glucose and fructose configuration. It is again non-reducing sugar because we see that the most right hand side of this compound is again fructose, which has OH free on the left hand side, which again reacts with the OH of the glucose, which is in the middle. Okay, so actually no OH on the right hand side, so it is a non-reducing sugar. Now raffinose and stachyose are undigestible carbohydrates, that is they cannot be digested, and these are mostly present in the beans, okay, and rajma that we eat. Okay, and these lead to gas problems. Okay, now honey, that is a one of the most popularly used food. Okay, it has two main monosaccharides. Okay, glucose and fructose. But then again, it has also both the natures of rotating the lights toward left or right, that is vector rotatory and lever rotatory. So it means that if it is asked what honey is constituted of, then you have to say glucose and fructose. Okay. Now it is not that order, the glucose dash fructose, it is not that order, it is just that two main monosaccharides, that is glucose and fructose. We have to not study much about it, but it has both the carbohydrates of natures of dextrorotatory and lever rotatory. Okay, this is very important. Honey is the only one here, no one else that has this special ability of dextrorotatory as well as lever rotatory. Now derivatives of monosaccharides can be also further derivated to other saccharides that are very well known, but we do not know the actual configuration of them, and because of lack of knowledge or something, we might hit some wrong options or wrong knowledge. Okay, these are again to be rote learned, nothing else. First one is deoxyribose sugar in DNA. Second one is amino sugar. It is, for example, glucosamine in chitin. It has amino group attached to the carbon 2. Then sugar acids are vitamin C, also known as ascorbic acid. Its deficiency leads to scurvy. Vitamin C research source is amla. Amla is also known as umbilica officinalis. Okay, and then we have other acids such as glucuronic and galacturonic. Glucuronic has the following structure. It has COOH instead of C2H2 in C6. Rest structure is exactly same as that of glucose. Okay, very easy. And then galacturonic has also the last carbon as COOH, and the fourth carbon also is here is having OH on the left hand side. Okay, very similar to that like of galactose. Now next we have degree of sweetening. Fourth one is sugar alcohol. An example, mannitol is a storage product of brown algae. Remember these four examples: deoxyribose sugar, amino sugar, sugar acids like vitamin C, glucuronic, galacturonic, and galacturonic, and sugar alcohol. Example, mannitol. Examples like glucosamine in chitin of amino sugar and vitamin C, ascorbic acid. Okay, just remember the examples and the names. Degree of sweetening: fructose has a degree of 170, followed by sucrose 100, glucose 72, maltose 32, and lactose 16. The fructose that is has the degree of sweetening of 170 is the sweetest of all naturally occurring sugar. It is the sweetest naturally occurring sugar that anyone can find. Now, the sweetest of all the naturally occurring substances, not sugar, is a protein called monilin, obtained from an African berry plant. This berry plant has a name, Diascorphylum cumensa. Diascorphylum cumensa. It is 2000 times sweeter than the sugar. The sugar count or degree of sweetening is 2 lakh. Okay, sugar is the common sucrose is the common sugar that we eat. It has degree of sweetening of 100. And this plant, that is Diascorphylum cumensa, has a degree of sweetening of 2 lakh. Another protein, Brazil, found from the other African berry. This name is Pentadiplantra brazina. The sugar count here is also 2 lakh. Both are proteins and they are low calorie sweeteners. Both are proteins, not sugar. One thing very important to remember, these are sugar but still less sweet than these two plants. Okay, these are 2 lakh having degree of sweetening, and the only thing to remember here is their last name, Brazina and Cumensa, because you will have to, okay, you will remember the first name easily. Artificial sweeteners such as saccharin and aspartame are very commonly used. As saccharin has a 40,000 degree of sweetening and aspartame has a 165,000 to approximately 1,70,000 degree of sweetening. Aspartame is used in Coca-Cola, and saccharin is supposed to be cancer causing. It is also thought to be carcinogenic, till now not proved. Polysaccharides. We know that there are more than nine monosaccharides combined to form polysaccharides. Polysaccharides are again of two types: homopolysaccharides and heteropolysaccharides. Homopolysaccharides are found by the polymerization of the same or only one or single type of monosaccharides. Heteropolysaccharides are formed by the polymerization of more than one monosaccharides. More important is homopolysaccharides, less important is heteropolysaccharides, because more questions are oftenly asked from homopolysaccharides. Now, the following are the examples of homopolysaccharides. Glucose on the polymerization gives glucan. Glucan has the following examples: starch, which is a storage protein; glycogen, which is again a storage protein; cellulose, which is a structural protein; fructose is again polymerized to form fructan, example inulin, it is not insulin, it is inulin. Inulin is a storage protein present in the roots of dahlia and artichoke plants. Artichoke plants are further to be remembered and learned in the next coming chapters in the plant physiology. And okay, just to remember the location, inulin is again a storage product. Okay, so starch, glycogen and inulin, these three are storage, and cellulose and chitin, okay, these two are structural. And N-acetyl glucosamine polymerase gives chitin, and again two are there which are not very important, but still arabinose gives araben, xylose gives xylene. Easy to remember. By polymerization of one more than one polysaccharides, we get the following heteropolysaccharides. Examples are agar-agar and mucopolysaccharides. Agar-agar is a polymer of mannose and galactose. Mannose and galactose, both are the epimers of glucose, as we had remembered. Okay, mannose difference if from the carbon position from the glucose in the carbon 2, and galactose, it is galactan, not galactose. Okay, and it is a semi-solid culture medium obtained from red algae. This agar-agar. Okay, now mucopolysaccharides are examples are heparin, pectin, and hemicellulose. It is found in the mucus like secretion that is obtained from the from the bhindi, that is also known as ladyfinger. Polymerization of glucose. Now here, if there is just a formula to be rote learned, nothing else. Again, polymerization of glucose, C6H6N, on liberalization of hydrogen, water, that is hydration, hydrolation, it will give C6H10O5. Just subtract one H2O from it, plus NH2O. Okay, so here to be correct, we should write here minus NH2O. But then again, biology, it's not calculation and number, so just a symbol that yes, H2O is removed. Okay, it is not fixed actually how much N or how much. Now question, there is a question, it may be asked or may not be: if N is 50 here, what will be the number of carbon atoms in the polymer of glucose? This is the polymer, and what will be the number of polymer of glucose? This is just to be remembered. Now see, here we know that 1H2O was subtracted here in the product side, but in the reactant we see that NH2O is added. There is absolutely nothing to do with this. It is just a simple reaction which may or may not be correct. What you have to do is just put the N value and get the atoms of the actual formed polymer and add 1H2O to it to obtain the polymer that would have been formed in the reactant product. Okay, see, we have subtracted only 1H2O, so here also we would get only 1H2O. But then again, this is what IQ says or logic says, but ma'am said it is not in bio. Nothing goes like calculations. There is a simple formula: whatever is the last obtained carbohydrate, just add 1H2O to it and you will get the numbers of all the three elements in the final product. So here put the 50, you will get C300 H500 O250, and add 1H2O to gain what you would get after polymerization of glucose. Carbohydrates are stored as polysaccharides because at every step of polymerization water is removed. As you see, water is removed, leading to concerns. Okay, so now question arises: why the storage, that is the storage forms of food that is stored in our body, are in the form of polysaccharides? Very good question. Why aren't they stored in the form of oligosaccharides or monosaccharides? The answer, very simple to it: carbohydrates are stored as polysaccharides because as the polymerization goes on, the water keeps gets removing, okay, and the carbohydrates get strings and shrinks and condenses and takes less space, and therefore would require less storage, okay, rather than monosaccharides, which would take up a lot of space, okay. They would just condense out all of the water out and would take less space in the body. Polysaccharides, or the second reason is polysaccharides are almost insoluble in water and will not affect osmotic concentration of cell. Yes, they are insoluble in water, they are very small. Okay, this is the only reason, but in other form, we know that insoluble things are helpful and they don't get easily dissolved in water as compared to monosaccharides. They will easily get repelled, but polysaccharides are almost insoluble in water and they do never affect the osmotic concentration inside the cell. Okay, so that is also a reason why they are stored as in this form. Polysaccharides also can be easily broken by enzymes, that is why they are kept in this form. Now, storage polysaccharides that we had just talked about: starch, glycogen, inulin. Starch is a storage polysaccharide in the plant. It is homopolysaccharide of alpha D glucose. Now, components of starch are amylose and amylopectin. Amylose is 20 to 30%, amylopectin is 70 to 80%. More soluble in water is amylose. Now, this is because it is smaller, so it gets easily dissolved. Amylopectin is very large, so less soluble in water. Amylose gives blue-black color with iodine. Amylopectin gives red-violet color with iodine. 98% of pea, mutter, starch is amylose. Potato also has most of the amylose. In activity in class 7th, in which we had put iodine or potato, gave blue-black color. Okay, that was because it has amylose. Now, 98% of waxy part of corn, okay, bhutta, is also amylopectin, and therefore it will give red violet color with iodine. One molecule of amylose is made up of 200 to approximately 1000 molecules of alpha glucose or alpha D glucose. Now, it is unbranched polymer, remember it, and it has only one alpha 1,4 glycosidic bond. Now, because it is coiled in a helical manner, it can hold iodine. Okay, see, this is the helical manner in which it is arranged. Now, it can store iodine in these forms and thus give a color and store the color, and it can be shown to the person who is doing the experiment. Okay, blue black color. Okay, and also in every helical turn, there are 6 glucose residue. Now, why residue here? Residue because we know that H2O is getting removed, okay, as the polymerization continues. So H2O, now water is removed, so what would be left? Residue. Okay, so these are known, every turn there are 6 glucose residues, and one molecule of now amylopectin, and one molecule of amylopectin is made up of 2000 to 2 lakh molecules of alpha glucose or alpha D glucose. It is a branched polymer with both alpha 1,4 and alpha 1,6 glycosidic bonds. Branching will occur after every 25 glucose residue, as we had here that every turn there will be 6 glucose residue. Here both both the straight branches as well as the perpendicular branches are also present here. Okay, not only the straight branches, okay, there will be branching, like this is branched because in the amylose there was single layer or single branch structure. It didn't have two or more than one branches, but amylopectin has a continuous long chain, and then there are branches attached to it, and then again chains are attached by branches. Okay, long chains, like going like parallel railway stations, and then cross bridges across through, and the cross bridges have one alpha 1,6 glycosidic linkage, and in simple branch have one alpha 1,4 glycosidic bonds. Now, branching occurs after every 25 glucose residue. As 25 glucose residue appear, one branch that connects the two long-running branches is present. Okay, alpha 1,6 is present only the point of branching. As I told, the straight chain part of molecule can be in helical. Okay, now the straight chain, that is the simple, the longer chain, is may or may not be helical. The straight chain is just said to be straight. It may or may not be straight because it may be in the form of helical like this. It may or may not be. Now glycogen, it is an animal starch. Okay, starch as we had learned, starch is again starch. Hello. Starch is acted upon by alpha amylose to form maltose, isomaltose, and limit dextrins. Maltose has 2 glucose with alpha 1,4 linkage. Isomaltose has 2 glucose with alpha 1,6 linkage. And limit dextrins is a small polymer of alpha D glucose. Glycogen, it is an animal starch. It stores the product of animals. And one molecule of glycogen is made up of 30,000 molecules of alpha D glucose. It is branched, and it has both the glycosidic bonds of alpha 1,4 and alpha 1,6. And since it is branched, so that is why it also has alpha 1,6. Now it will give red violet color with amylopectin. And since it gives red violet color, that means it has more amylopectin than the amylose, okay, because it gives red violet color, and so it will have amylopectin. Now stored in liver and muscles, as one animal gets killed, the glycogen in its body that is present in liver and muscles will no longer be obtained as food to the other animal, because more or less the enzymes in the liver and the muscles convert the glycogen into lactic acid. So ultimately no glycogen can be obtained as the animal dies. Now diagrammatic representation of small portion of glycogen. See, this is the glycogen in the NCRT long chain. Now this is A and this is B. Now A junction and B junction. A junction is actually the alpha 1,4 and B junction is actually the alpha 1,6. Now here is that same representation. Now here we see that this is the long straight chain. Now here we have simple alpha D glucoses, dheer sare hain, and in between every two glucose there is alpha 1,4 glycosidic bond, which is this A bond. Here exactly you can see this. Now here when the B that is present in that diagram also is attached, okay, it is also a simple long chain branch, and these two branches are attached by the B branch, that is alpha 1,6 glucoside. Now alpha 1,6 glucose is what? Now the fifth glucose, that is carbon 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Sixth glucose, that is the last glucose, has CH2OH. Now and the first carbon has OH and OH. So CH2OH and HOH combine to form H2O2, and one H2O is get liberated, so only left is O. Okay, it is very similar to this, but only here is that the difference between here and here, this one is that we had only one CH, okay, when only one H and OH on the C1. If you talk on every C1 like this and this and this, okay, all will have H upon OH. You see here H upon OH, so it would react with the other H upon OH, that is of the C4 of the left hand side of other alpha D glucose, to form H2O2. Okay, just try to combine. Now H2O2 is not the final, because H2O gets liberated, so only thing that remains is O. Similarly here, instead of HOH there is CH2OH and H OH here and CH2OH here, so OH O remains and H2O related. This is the diagram which is in NCERT. Nothing is explained here, okay. Now but this diagram a lot more is explained, and this diagram is more explained in this way. This is the same diagram, but here you see only CH2 and then bond is formed and nothing else is told. Okay, here also this the same thing. Now next thing is inulin. It is a homopolymer of fructose. We had read about it as we were learning about the homopolysaccharides. Okay, now structural polysaccharides. This is very simple and easy topic. As we had just studied about this, this is the structural polysaccharide. We had just remembered about the storage polysaccharide. This is the structural polysaccharide, and this has only two things to be learned: chitin and cellulose. Chitin is the second most abundant organic molecule in the biosphere. It is a complete homopolymer of the N-acetyl glucosamine. It was an example in the homopolysaccharide versus heteropolysaccharide table. That was on the first of this video. Now it is unbranched polymer. Okay, very easy to remember because it has only beta 1,4 glycosidic linkage. It has no beta 1,6. Okay, so this way you can also remember that it is unbranched. Now it is present in the exocellular. We know that chitin is also present in the cell wall of the fungi. Very easy. We also know that we remember that in class 6 and 7. Now it is also present in the 6 exoskeleton of arthropods, that is crabs and other creatures which have exoskeleton, snails. Now it itself, by itself, chitin is very soft and leathery, like mushroom. We have it in mushroom. We know that how fungus is actually, but it becomes hard due to deposition of calcium in arthropods exoskeleton. Now N-acetyl, why do we have N-acetyl glucosamine? Why do we have N here? N represents NH group. Okay. Then again, the whole structure is not important. The carbon second, that is which comes after carbon number one, has this structure. Okay, we had remembered, if you remember, okay, you must be remembering, but in the botany class we had remembered that the cell wall of the primitive the cells are made up of NAG and NAM. Okay, so the NAG there was this NAG there, N-acetyl glucosamine, and the NAM, that is NAM, was N-acetyl muramic acid. Now the only difference between N-acetyl glucosamine and N-acetyl muramic acid was that okay, the structure was same, NH and then CO, ketonic, and then CH3. Okay, same. But in this carbon, that is carbon number 3 carbon, there are 4 NH3 subunits. Okay, a chain of 4 NH3 here. Okay, nothing else was difference in NAG and NAM, and we know that the cross chain form, and then they form this cell wall. Okay, now cellulose. It is the most abundant organic molecule in this hemisphere. Now cellulose contains approximately 6,000 beta glucose. Why beta glucose? Because every single thing in cellulose is beta. Also in chitin it is beta, and in starch it was alpha. Okay. Now unbranched polymer. It is an unbranched polymer with only beta 1,4 glucosidic linkage. Beta, since it has no beta 1,6, so it is unbranched. Okay, now maximum amount of cellulose is present in the cotton. Okay, and 90% of cotton is cellulose. 90% of cotton is cellulose. It has wood has 25 to 50% cellulose. Paper is also made up of cellulose on hydrolysis of cellulose. In the end, a disaccharide called cellobiose is obtained with B1,4 glycosidic linkage. It is a reducing sugar. Again, it is a reducing sugar. Now this is to be remembered, cellobiose, that is formed on the hydrolysis of cellulose in the last stage. Okay, and it has, again, it is unbranched, and but it is reducing sugar. Now question is, why cellulose gives no color with iodine? Because it has no, it is an unbranched unbranched polymer of beta glucose. It does not have coil helicals in which iodine would get stored and show its color, that were red violet and the blue black. Okay, none of them would be shown because no helical is present here, no circular those waves where iodine could be trapped. Okay, so therefore ultimately no, it has Okay. Now, none of vertebrates can produce cellulose digesting enzyme, that is beta amylase, of course. Since beta everywhere, so amylase. Now, beta amylase, we know that the cellulose is digested by amylase. Since cellulose is the polymer of the beta glucose, it is digested by beta amylase. Cellulose gets digested by amylase. So herbivores like cow and buffalo depend on symbiotic digestion. The symbiotic digestion means bacteria present in the guts of these ruminant animals help in eating them these cellulose, that is the cellulose. Okay, they cannot eat this. Okay, they can't. So for eating this cellulose, they need the help of this symbiotic digestion, and that is present in animalic canal. Okay, cow and buffalo only. No vertebrate can actually produce it. So this is about this. And also these cellulose is an important component in our balanced diet. But again, we cannot digest it. So how can it be a component of balanced diet? Because it acts as roughage. Okay, it absorbs the water and prevents constipation. Constipation is the process when the dry fecal then it is called constipation, dry fecal. So it absorbs water and goes out with the fecal. So that helps in preventing constipation. Now, derivatives of cellulose. Okay, cellulose again is a very important topic, because cellulose, as we had remembered, it is the most abundant organic molecule in the biosphere. So it definitely requires special attention. Derivatives of cellulose. First derivative is cellulose xanthate, that is also known as rayon. Now, natural silk is not actually it is a protein, that is fibroin. Artificial silk is rayon. Okay, that is cellulose xanthate. It is prepared by dissolving wood chips, that is wood chips, in NaOH, okay, sodium hydroxide, caustic soda. If solution is passed through spinneret, then okay, rayon thread is obtained. This is just a machine there that forms threads. Okay, so wood chips and NaOH mix, then pass through a spinneret machine, then spins or thread are obtained. And if the solution, that is wooden chip plus NaOH, is just pressed, it forms cellophane sheet. We have remembered this in also botany. Okay, cellophane sheet is semi-permeable, and mishead differentiated semi-permeable, and the selective permeable. So this is present in the semi-permeable membrane, and the cellophane sheet gets obtained. Now, cellulose acetate is the second derivative of cellulose. It is prepared by dissolving wood chips, that were the same component of cellulose xanthate, with acetic acid, not NaOH. The difference only is this. Now, it is used for making terricot fiber, the only important thing, and the rest not important but rare. Okay, cigarette filtrate, that is the brown part of the cigarette, double net fiber, and the shatterproof glasses. Okay, this is all about cellulose acetate. Now, the next, cellulose nitrate. Now, this is used by the terrorist to perform the bomb blast in the aeroplanes. And that is why more than 100 ml or 10 ml water not allowed, liquid not allowed in the aeroplane. Now, it is prepared by dissolving cellulosic chips, the cellulose chips, in nitric acid. It is just the wood chips, but fancying the name, okay, cellulose is wood. Now, it is chips in the nitric acid. Now, acetic acid was cellulose acetate, and present in the caustic soda was xanthate, and nitric acid is nitrate. It is a propellant explosive. Now, CMC, that is carboxymethyl cellulose. It is a very good emulsifier. Now, what is emulsifier? Emulsifier were the topic that we had done in class 8th, okay, chemistry. Now, it prevents freezing. Used in the preparation of the ice cream, cosmetics, medicine, and jelly. Every single thing that is kept very in the low temperature, but is not meant to be freeze. Okay, what if you had ice instead of ice cream? Okay, if we put kulfi in the fridge, okay, it will get like solid hard, but if you put ice cream, it will still be creamy. Similarly, cosmetics, okay, creams and lipsticks are put in the refrigerator, medicines are in the put in the fridges for because they cannot get freezed. Okay, they are treated with emulsifiers so that they could be used again, and same case with jelly. Now mucopolysaccharides, this is very important, just like cellulose. This is also important. It is little small, okay, but still it is very important topic. Many questions could be asked. It is also known as slimy carbohydrate. We remember that we had just done that it was present in the bhindi or kya kehte hain, lady finger, okay, and it is the same thing. Now let us learn about this. Mucopolysaccharides are heterosaccharides. They are formed by the polymerization of acidic or aminated, that is nitrated, glucose, galactose or mannose. These three, the glucose, galactose and mannose, are the epimers of glucose, we know that. Now these are formed by the polymerization of either acidic or aminated, okay, aminated, okay, glucose, galactose or mannose. Now it is of the following types, or it is actually of the following examples. These are the following examples: hyaluronic acid, okay, hyaluronic acid. It is formed by the combination of glucuronic acid, that is also known as eduronic acid, plus N-acetylglucosamine. The hyaluronic acid acts as a binder, or binding the cells in a tissue together. The cells in a tissue are binded together by hyaluronic acid. The vitreous humor of our eye is also hyaluronic, formed by hyaluronic acid. The synovial fluid between the two articulating bones or joints is also hyaluronic acid. Here it is, it acts as lubricant between the two joints. Now chondroitin sulfate is present in the matrix of cartilage. It is formed by glucuronic acid and AAG, that is acetylaminogalactose. Keratin sulfate, keratin, not keratin. It is not tin, it is tan. Keratin sulfate. It is present in the cornea of eye. Okay, just remember the location and what is formed of it. Okay, chondroitin sulfate. Okay, chondroitin means cartilage. Now remember its structure. And then hyaluronic acid, you just have to remember structure. And then vitreous humor of eye, synovial fluid, articulating bones, and then it helps in the binding of other. Now keratin sulfate present in the skin and cornea of eye. It provides them strength and flexibility. It is also formed by galactohyaluronic acid and N-acetylglucosamine, similar to that of hyaluronic acid. Mucopolysaccharides are found when we cut the bhindi or lady finger. That is also it has the name of the Hibiscus esculentus, also earlier known as Abel Moses, and the slimy fluid that comes out when we cut the vegetable. This is actually an example of mucopolysaccharide. Purgatives, that is also known as the things that were used for the treatment of constipation, are actually mucopolysaccharides because they help in formation of mucus and for better flow of the fecal. Okay, now it is present in the husk of isobagel, also known as plantago vata. These are just to be remembered, nothing else. And now Aloe barbadensis is also a purgative, helps in constipation, treatment of constipation. And then again there is aloe vera, very famous for its mucopolysaccharide. Okay, is a very good moisturizer used in skin cosmetics. Phycocolloids are the cells present, the colloids present in the cell wall of the algae. We had remembered agar, okay, heteropolysaccharide. This is also mucopolysaccharide, but just a fancy name of or type of mucopolysaccharide. It is in red algae, it is present in the agar and carrageenan. It is used in the preparation of toothpaste, chocolate and jelly. And from brown algae, we obtain a polysaccharide called alginic acid. Very important again, and one question was asked in name, some mistold. And they are generally present in the cooler waters of the world. So how do they survive in the cool water? Because of this acid on the cover of this mucopolypeptide, okay, they don't freeze because of this polysaccharide. And this polysaccharide is an example of mucopolysaccharide is an example of phycoalkaloids. This is now if examples are come like both polysaccharide, saccharide, mucopolysaccharide and phycoalkaloids. Now both four, all four, it the alginic acid is a polysaccharide, it is a saccharide, okay, so it is a saccharide, and in saccharide it is a polysaccharide, and in polysaccharide it is a mucopolysaccharide, and in mucopolysaccharide it is a phycoalkaloid. So all four are correct, but you have to mark phycoalkaloids because you also know in which category it falls under. Okay, now these are generally present in the cooler waters of the world, but they do not freeze because of this presence of this alginic acid, brown algae. And then used in the preparation of shampoo, toothpaste, okay, anything that is flexible and mucus like, and anything else, shampoo mucus like, toothpaste mucus like, jelly dense mucus like, ice cream also mucus like, slimy and soft and creamy, and okay, surgical thread that gets dissolved in the human body even after the surgery. And then salts of alginic acid, this alginic acid are also used by density to make the impressions of the preparation of the dentures. Okay, now they don't use plaster of Paris. Okay, many people say that they use plaster of Paris for making the dentures. No, if they would do that, then teeth, everything else would come out. Okay, what they use is salts of this alginic acid because it needs to be slimy. Okay, they need to mold to that structure of teeth, and then it would be recorded, and then again dentures or like old age people, okay, that would be formed. Now heparin, hemicellulose and pectin are examples of mucopolysaccharides. We had remembered there also in the heteropolysaccharides. Okay, so also it is a heteropolysaccharide. Now this is also a thing remembered. Alginic, now okay, I'm talking about heparin again. Overview, it is a saccharide, that is a carbohydrate. It is heparin, also known as saccharide. In the saccharide it is polysaccharide. It is a heteropolysaccharide. In heteropolysaccharide is a mucopolysaccharide, and mucopolysaccharide only. It is not an example of phycoalkaloids. Okay, phycoalkaloids until here, these three were the examples of just mucopolysaccharides. Now over, very long video. Okay.